Now, President Pranab Mukherjee will list the priorities of Narendra Modi-led NDA government when he will address a joint sitting of Parliament today. The President's address will be in the Central Hall of Parliament and will lay the roadmap of the new government.
62 महिलाएं पहली बार चुनकर संसद आई हैं, जो अब तक का एक रिकॉर्ड है. अलग-अलग मायने.
Now, a key focus area of the new government is to nurse the economy back into high growth mode.
Honorable members, I am delighted to address this first session of both houses of parliament after the elections to the 16th Lok Sabha. Let me begin by extending warm greetings to my fellow citizens who participated in large numbers in the recently concluded Lok Sabha elections. We should never forget that we are here because of them. Serving them should be our first priority. I also felicitate the members of the new Lok Sabha. You have successfully obtained the mandate from the electorate, and now you represent their hopes, aspirations, and dreams. I extend a warm welcome to all of you and hope that the sessions ahead, with heavy legislative agenda, will be productive and useful. It is a matter of great satisfaction that the recent general elections were smooth and largely peaceful. I would like to congratulate the Election Commission of India and the official machinery for conducting these elections successfully. The unprecedented interest shown by the people of India in the elections is a sign of progressive deepening of our vibrant democracy. Before I dwell upon the tasks ahead of us, I would like to express my solidarity with the families of all those who lost their lives during the election process. I congratulate the new Speaker of Lok Sabha on her unanimous election to this august office. By successively selecting women speakers, the Lok Sabha has reaffirmed our age-old belief in the importance of women in our society. Honorable members, this has been an election of hope. It marks a turning point in the evolution of our democratic polity. The surge in aspirations and the belief that these could be realized through democratic process has been amply reflected in the record 66.4% participation by voters and a clear verdict in favor of a single political party after a gap of nearly 30 years. The electorate transcended the boundaries of caste, creed, region, and religion to come together and vote precisely in favor of development through good governance. Honorable members, the country needed a strong and stable government that could provide effective leadership. In my Republic Day speech earlier this year, I had hoped for 2014 to be a year of healing after the fractured and contentious politics of the previous years. Standing here today, I applaud the wisdom of my fellow citizens for having voted for stability, honesty, and development in a resurgent India in which corruption will have no place. They have voted for a united, strong and modern India, Ek Bharat, Shrestha Bharat. My government will work to fulfill these aspirations with the involvement of all the 125 crore people of this great country. My government is committed to nurturing the right environment, of actualizing this mandate of the people. For this, it pledges itself to the principle of Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas, which can be fulfilled only through your active participation. We will work together to re-establish the credibility of the institutions of democracy. My government will function on the mantra of minimum government, maximum governance. In all our actions, we will be guided by the core values of our great civilization. Honorable members, my government is dedicated to the poor. Poverty has no religion. Hunger has no creed. Despair has no geography. The greatest challenge before us is to end the curse of poverty in India. My government will not be satisfied with the mere poverty alleviation and commits itself to the goal of poverty elimination. With a firm belief that the first claim on development belongs to the poor, the government will focus its attention on those who need the basic necessities of life most urgently. It will take necessary steps to provide security in its entirety to all citizens through empathy, support, and empowerment. Containing food inflation will be the topmost priority for my government. There would be an emphasis on improving the supply side of various agro and agro-based products. My government will take effective steps to prevent hoarding and black marketing. It will reform the public distribution system, incorporating best practices from the states. My government is alert about the possibility of a subnormal monsoon this year, and contingency plans are being prepared. Despite more than two-thirds of our people living in rural areas, we have not been able to provide adequate public amenities and livelihood opportunities to them. My government is committed to improving the quality of life in our villages through empowered Panchayati Raj institutions. A substantial part of investment will focus on creating community assets and improving basic infrastructures such as roads, shelter, power and drinking water. My government will strive to end the rural-urban divide, guided by the idea of Rurban, providing urban amenities to rural areas while preserving the ethos of the villages. Agriculture is the source of livelihood for majority of our people. In the recent past, our farmers have been under severe stress, with hopelessness driving some of them to suicides. My government is committed
to reversing this unfortunate trend. It will increase investment in agriculture, both public and private, especially in agri-infrastructure. Steps will be taken to convert farming into a profitable venture through scientific practice and agro-technology. My government will address issues pertaining to pricing and procurement of agricultural products, crop insurance, and post-harvest management. Productivity of animal husbandry will be increased. My government will incentivize the setting up of food processing industries. Existing cooperative sector laws will be reviewed to remove anomalies and lacuna. My government will adopt a national land use policy which will facilitate scientific identification of non-cultivable land and its strategic development. Honorable members, each drop of water is precious. My government is committed to giving high priority to water security. It will complete the long-pending irrigation projects on priority and launch the Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sinchai Yojana with the motto of Khor Khet Ko Pani. There is a need for seriously considering all options, including linking of rivers where feasible, for ensuring optimal use of our water resources to prevent the recurrence of floods and drought. By harvesting rainwater through Jal Sanchay and Jal Sinchan, we will nurture water conservation and groundwater recharge. Micro-irrigation will be popularized to ensure per drop more crop. Honorable members, India is the world's oldest civilization. Today it is also a country with the largest population of the youth. We must equip and nurture our youth with the right kind of education, skill set, and opportunity to reap this demographic dividend. My government will strive to transition from youth development to youth-led development. It will set up massive open online courses and virtual classrooms. It will formulate a national education policy aimed at meeting the challenges posed by lack of quality, research and innovation in our educational institutions. We will set up IITs and IIMs in every state in order to empower school teachers and students. A national e-library will be established with the motto Har Hath Ko Hunar. My government will strive to break the barriers between formal education and skill development and put in place a mechanism to give academic equivalence to vocational qualifications